Hello everyone, I welcome you all to this Power Electronic video section series. So in this lecture we are going to see the different types of chopper circuits. Let us see the classification of chopper circuits. Generally the DC chopper circuits are classified as per the direction of the voltage and current. So depends upon the current and voltage polarity, the choppers are classified into 5 categories: class A, class B, class C, class D and class E. So generally class A chopper is nothing but a first quadrant chopper which is operated in first quadrant. Class B chopper is a second quadrant operator, only operated in second quadrant. Class C chopper, it's a two quadrant operation, first and second quadrant. Class D chopper, also a two quadrant, but it is operated in first and fourth quadrant. Class 4 chopper is a four quadrant operation. In all four quadrants, operation is possible in class A chopper. So let us see the class A chopper detailed analysis. So this is the basic configuration of a class A chopper, which is having a one switch and a freewheeling diode connected to a load. Normally the class A chopper comes under the category of step down chopper. So it may not be all step down choppers are not class A choppers, but class A chopper comes under the category of step down chopper. So that means the output voltage you will get which is lesser than input voltage, and the operation is class A chopper is generally defined in first quadrant operation. That means if you observe the quadrants of the voltage and current, so the voltage and current, both the polarity should be positive, voltage should be positive and the current direction should be positive. So this type of operation of first quadrant operation comes with your class A chopper working. Now when the thyristor is conducting, that means when the chopper is closed, the source voltage is applied across the load. When the thyristor is not conducting, with the freewheeling diode, the voltage applied across the load is zero. So these two are the modes of operation. When the switch is on, the voltage source is applied across the load. When switch is off, with the freewheeling diode, the voltage applied, because the freewheeling diode is short circuited, the voltage applied across this is zero. Now you can see. So when the thyristor is on condition, we will get a source voltage. When it is off condition, we won't get any voltage because it is zero. So like this, we will get output voltage. For a resistive load of this average voltage, our average voltage of this condition, V average is equals to the source voltage into, so how much time the switch is on, T on by T on plus T off, and that is the V into T on by T, that is also called as alpha V duty ratio, where V is the applied voltage, V average value of output voltage, T on is the turn on time, total time is equals to turn on plus turn off time, and alpha or nothing but a duty ratio is the T on by T. Now when the control pulse is applied to the switch is turned on, the output voltage equal to supply voltage, and at that condition, when it is a resistive load, the current also equal to, because it is a resistive load, the current through the load is equals to V naught by R in this period. So when the electronic switch becomes open, the output voltage and current is equals to zero. So then your relation will get V naught is equals to V when it is at T on. It is a zero when it is T on to T total, that means half period. So we'll get a equation of average voltage V naught. Just now we have seen it is a duty ratio of voltage and current is equals to V naught by R. Similarly, the RMS value of the output current, we can calculate the voltage and current values. V RMS value is equals to, it is a root, mean value and square value of the voltage. So we'll get a root of duty ratio into voltage. So similarly, the current IRMS value, we'll get a root D V by, simply because it is a resistive load, V by R. And the output power is given by P output is equals to V RMS square by R. R, it's I square R, so alpha V square by R watts. So this is the analysis of resistive load. So analysis of step down or class A chopper with RLE load condition. Normally when the load is connected RLG, so where otherwise a motor is connected, generally the chopper circuits we can connect to drive the control the DC motor. So when the motor is connected, the back EMF is acted as a key. So when RLE is connected, so depends upon L value, depends upon the L value, your current value will be changed. If it is the L value is more, we will get a continuous conduction mode, and if L is less, we will get a discontinuous conduction mode. So the detailed analysis of continuous conduction mode and discontinuous conduction mode we already explained in the step down chopper. So class A chopper, we can conclude one point clearly, that voltage polarity is positive and current polarity is positive, that's why it is working as a first quadrant chopper. Now coming to the class B chopper, it is also called as a second quadrant chopper. So the configuration of class B chopper, a reverse biased diode and the switch is connected, and a RLE load we can connect. So R is invisible, you may connect R load, RLE load also, or it is a DC motor can be connected also at this place of E. So as it is generally, we can say the class B chopper is a step up chopper. Its operation is equivalent to step up operation. So when you see the quadratic operation of this, the voltage value is positive and the current polarity is negative. So we will get a voltage polarity positive and current polarity negative. So voltage polarity positive means this is whatever this condition positive, V naught positive and minus, this is the voltage polarity positive. But the current direction is the reverse direction to this one. I naught is, if it is considering this is the positive direction, the reverse direction of this will cause the negative direction. So it is also a one quadrant chopper but operates in second quadrant. The load voltage is positive and the load current is negative. So here also the two modes of operation, when the switch is off, when the switch is closed, and when the switch is off condition. Let us see the operation. So class B chopper, it's generally used for regenerative braking of the motor. So we'll see what is the regenerative braking at the end of the explanation of the class B chopper. So provide the positive output voltage and negative output current, right? So when the average power flows from load to source, when the current is flowing from reverse direction, that means the current is flowing from load to source. Voltage is positive but current is negative means the current is flowing from load to source. That's why it is a regenerative braking. That means so the source, the value, the power will be flowing from load to source. So it is a possible for a speed above the rated speeds in DC motor condition, nearly zero speed condition. So applications of generally will use this class B chopper for regenerative braking and battery applications. So we'll see the worst when the switch is closed. When the switch is closed, so this will act as a source and the current direction will be in the IA reverse direction, and voltage value will be positive with respect to this source, and the inductor will start charging, inductor current will be increased. So from 0 to T on, the switch will be closed and current direction will be in this direction and inductor starts charging. So and the VA value is 0 because the switch is closed and it is short circuited. IA starts increasing due to E, and the mechanical energy is converted into mechanical energy if it is a motor is connected. So the energy starts storing in the inductor L, and any remaining energy is dissipated in the L. So this mode of operation we are calling energy storage interval, because the energy which will be starts storing in the inductor from the E. So from this mode of operation we can write an equation RA IA, the resistance of R IA plus LA DIA by DT is equals to E. This is the KVL, simple KVL equation we can apply. And second mode of operation, when the switch is off, T on to T, that means when the switch is off condition, so what will happen now, the inductor is stored and there is a source. Now inductor starts releasing its energy, now current direction will be the same previous direction and the diode now conducts and the energy will be transferred from so load to source, right? So IA flows through the diode and source. IA start decreasing because inductor is releasing its energy, so that it decreases in the negative direction. And energy stored in the LA, energy supplied to the machine or fed to the source. So your equation will becomes now RAIM LADI by DT plus V is equals to E. So this interval we are calling that is a duty interval IA. It is a discharging interval, duty interval here. So now your duty cycle is equals to delta is equals to T on by T, where T is the choking period. So under steady state condition, the generator side, your voltage equation VA is equals to your source voltage VA is equals to E minus RA IA. From the chopper side, this equation from the generator side. Now from the chopper side, the average armature voltage VA is equals to 1 minus duty cycle time duty ratio into V. Therefore, so 1 minus delta V is equals to VA is equals to E minus RA IA. So hence the average armature current value we can write E minus 1 minus delta V by RA. So we can see the waveform clearly here. From 0 to on period, that means the delta T period, the chopper is on. So the inductor current and armature current starts increasing, it will rise up to this point. Now when the chopper circuit is off, then the current will be decreased reverse mode. So again it will be switched on. So this period, first period is called as energy storage interval, and next period is called duty interval. So always this value is negative because the current, it will act as a motor. So this is the complete waveform. So when the T is off, so obviously the current value will be decreased in the reverse side. You can see this is the reference line of the current. So current value will be the current value is increased in the reverse direction. And when the T is on, the current in the inductor will be released, again it will be decreased. And the current is increased, current is decreased, current is increased, and current is decreased. So the voltage across the load is when the T is on, that voltage is applied across this load. Otherwise the voltage is zero. Now coming to class C chopper, it is a two quadrant chopper. So here the class C chopper consists of four switches, two switches, two SCRs and two diodes. T1 and T2 are the two switching devices, control switching devices, and D1, D2 are the diodes which are uncontrolled. Now, when you see the operation of this class C, the class C chopper is operated in two quadrants, it is a quadrant 1 and quadrant 2. So in quadrant 1, voltage and current both are positive. In quadrature 2, voltage is positive but current is negative. Now, so that it is a combination of class A and class B choppers connected in parallel. Now for motoring operation, forward motoring operation, Q1 and T1, that means quadrature 1. So T1 and D2 will be operated, so it's like a class A chopper. For a forward braking, regenerative braking, quadrature 2, so T2 and D2 will, D1 will be operated, it is like a class B chopper. So let us see. So VA is always positive, load is always positive, and IA can be positive or negative. So from this we can see voltage value is always positive, but current value, it may be a positive or it may be a negative. IA can be positive or negative. So do not fire both the switches. Here when one precautionary thing we have to remember, the switch T1 and T2 cannot be switched on at a time. So because when both are switched on at a time, the source will be dead, short circuited. So it will be damaged to the source. So that's why we cannot switch on and T1 and T2 at a time. It will be short circuited. Now we'll see the modes of operation of a class C chopper. For forward quadrating, quadrate one operation, first a T1 is connected. So first will in quadrature 1, T1 and D2 will be connected. It's a class A operation. When the T1 is conducting, so the source is connected series to the load. So the current direction is a positive. The voltage is also a positive. So the average voltage VA is equals to how much time it is on depends upon the duty ratio delta 1 V. So your delta 1 is equals to T on by T, and delta 2 is equals to 0 because always T2 is 0. T2 is always 0. Now once the T1 is switched off, automatically D2 is conducting. Now the whatever the inductance is here, it will be releases its energy and the current will be decreases in the same direction. Here the voltage is also positive and current is also a positive. Voltage is 0. The current direction will be, it will be decreasing, positive polarity decreasing. Now we'll see the mode 3 operation for forward braking quadrant 2 operation. So in this mode of operation, T2 and D1 will be conducting. So first we'll see D1 conduction. Now when T2 is not conducting, so D1 will be conducted. So the current, whatever the stored energy in the inductor from the battery E, which will be giving to the source. So this condition will happen when the back EMF generated by the motor, which value is greater than whatever the source voltage. That means this will happen when the speed is greater than normal speed and regenerative condition. So in this condition, your back EMF is greater than your voltage. So the current will be flowing from load to source. So at this condition, D1 is on. The average voltage VA is equals to 1 minus delta 2 V. So delta 1 is always 0 because the T1 is always off. Delta 2 is equals to T on 2 divided with T. Now we will switch on the T2. When the switch on the T2, so obviously the current direction will be negative. So which is passing through the T2 and it will be discharged through this path. The current starts, whatever the inductance part in this load, this will be releases it in energy and it will be decreased. So this is the average voltage is negative here. So this is the voltage applied across this load. So very clearly we can see it. So in this mode, the voltage is positive, current is positive. When the D2 is connecting, voltage is positive and current is positive. When D1 is connecting, current is negative and voltage is positive. And when T2 is conducting, current is negative and voltage is positive. So in quadrature 1, voltage and current both are positive, and quadrature 2, so voltage is positive but current is negative. Very clearly we can see the waveforms of class E choker. So when the T is on, that means the T1 is on, the current will be positive direction, it will be increased. That means in this charging mode. So when this is not happening, so diode D2 will be connect, so it will be discharges the current 0. Now when the T2 is on, then it will be charged in the reverse direction. Reverse direction, the current will be increased. Again the D1 is conducting, so it will be discharged. Same thing will be repeated. So that's why, so we can clearly say the voltage applied across the load is always positive and the current is varying sometimes when it is a positive and it is a negative. So the two quadrant operation can be possible with class C choker. The basic important points we can remember from the class C choker. When both the average load voltage and average load current are positive, so when both voltage and current are positive, then whatever the load we can connect, suppose it is a motoring operation takes place when it is a DC motor connected. Generally, class E choker can be used for speed control of DC motor, so that's why we are using a motor terminology here. So when both the average load voltage and load current positive, then whatever the load connected, it acted as a motor. DC machine acted as a motor. So when the average load is positive and load current is negative, that means so that motor operates in the braking mode. Now for higher duty ratios of T1, when the duty ratio of T1 is higher, the average output voltage is greater than back EMF, so it acts as a motor. So source is greater than load, it is act as a motor. The chopper operated as a driving mode. Now for lower duty ratios, when the lower duty ratio, the output voltage becomes greater than source voltage, so then it will act as a regenerative braking of DC drive. These are the important points of type C chopper. Thank you very much. The remaining choppers will be explained in the next series of videos.